Text online navigation becomes a great match to the prevailing use and popularity of the smartphone age. Search engines also provide a system of giving the best and most appropriate results. Mobile phone application has been added to smartphones for quick, handy research and quicker school assignments. In this lesson, you are expected to use the internet as a tool to gather specific information and developing on a given situation. Search engines are software systems that are designed to search for information on the World Wide Web. The search results are generally presented in a line of results often referred to as search engine results pages. Examples of search engines are Baidu, Bing, Yahoo, DuckDuckGo, and the most recognized engine, Google. Google is the most known and most used search engines in the world, according to the net market share of 74.54% of the search engine market has been acquired by Google. Web navigation refers to the process of navigating a network of information resources in the World Wide Web, which is organized by hypertext and hypermedia. The user interface that is used to do so is called a web browser. Today, we will learn about how to use the internet as a tool to gather information. Text in online navigation. First, from your desktop or laptop, go to your web browser. Then once the web browser will pop up, just type the keywords, phrase or thoughts that you want to search. For example, effects of social media to student. Then just right click. Then on the upper right side of your browser, just click the setting and click the advanced search. Then the advanced search is built-in feature of Google and in most search websites that allows a user to specify additional requirements for a research. When you used for searching the web, an advanced search gives additional information to Google which helps refine the research or the search. You might remember a time when you took lessons at your school library about how to use the card catalog to find specific books by an author, title, or subject, and knowing how to use the card about the specific subject, knowing how to use the advanced search on Google will make you better at finding what you are looking for on the web. So, ibig sabihin, this advanced search po is pinifilter niya kung ano po talaga yung gusto nating makita. Okay, kung ano yung related literature, kung ano yung related research, related thoughts, related words na gusto nating makita at mabasa sa internet. In order to achieve or access what you are looking for, you need to improve yourself. As the old saying goes, practice makes perfect. Good research is a product of multiple and continuous searches. Here are some skills you can improve or adapt to. First, critical thinking. As you search through the web, you must think very carefully about the information that you have gathered. Critical thinking involves the ability to reflect on the information presented to you. Next, data organizing. A good researcher can organize his or her collected data. As you collect those data, be sure to track where specific information is gathered. Third, research presenting. Part of your research is the actual writing. Be creative and reflective in writing your research. Explain every detail and step into achieving your objective. The copyright infringement. If you create something, an idea, an invention, a form of literary work, or a research, you have the right as to how it should be used by others. It is called intellectual property. In other words, the copyright law includes your rights over your work, and anyone who uses it without your consent is punishable by law. Try grabbing any book, then browse its first few pages, and you will find a page with a disclaimer with the words, "No part of this book may be copied, reproduced." That is copyright page. As a responsible user of the internet, you have to consider that not everything out there is free for you to use. Just like your own, contents that you see from websites have their respective copyrights. There are several instances where employees or business owners have faced copyright infringement and are sentenced to a huge fine due to reckless copying of materials. Here are some tips that could help you avoid copyright infringement. First, understand. Copyright protects literary work, photographs, paintings, drawings, films, and music. But it generally does not protect underlying ideas and facts. This means that you can express something using your own words, but you should give credit to the source. Next, be responsible. Even if a material does not say that it is copyright, it is not a valid defense against copyright. Be responsible enough to know if something has a copyright. Third, be creative. Ask yourself whether what you are making is something that came from you or something made from somebody else's creativity. It is important to add your own creative genius in everything that will be created or credited to you. Fourth, know the law. There are some limitations to copyright laws. For instance, in the Philippines, copyright only lasts a lifetime of the author plus 50 years. There are also provisions for fair use, which mean that an intellectual property may be used without a consent as long as it is used in commentaries, criticisms, search engines, parodies, news reports, research, library archiving, teaching, and education. If you have doubts that what you are doing does not fall under the policy of fair use, seek permission first. Another misconception is that fan fiction is not copyright infringement. In reality, it is, and some copyright holders ignore them, but they can opt to use their rights.